Let's take a look at the model here, or the problem here about chickens. This is from the NCTM. It was in Illuminations. There's a couple other varieties of this problem, but I like this one. It's got some decimals in it. It makes people a little bit uncomfortable. So let's explore this. The solution, one of the solutions that I found that's pretty straightforward, you probably see it. I'll discuss that in a little while, but most students will take a look at this problem and start delving right in and working with systems of equations, which is a good plan to create a model for this. So let's just go ahead and do that and see how that goes. All right, so we're looking at a system of equations here. So I want a system that's a 3 by 3, so I just press the system twice. If I call the large chicken X, the medium chicken Y, and the small chicken, I'm gonna put in 0 Z. I'll set that equal to 10.6. On the second one, I've got a large chicken and a very small chicken, so that's a large plus no medium plus 1 of the small, and that's giving me a total of 8.5. And then finally, my last equation has no large chickens. It has a medium and a small. And those end up giving me a total of 6.1. The system of equations can be solved by hand. It takes a little work, a little getting used to. You have to add a couple of things together. You got to do a couple of eliminations in order to get there, but it's doable. You could also do it by substitution. We have to do a couple of substitutions here and there, but if we just want to see what our solution is, there we have it. There's our decimal. The problem wants to know what one of each one of these is, so we would add an X plus a Y plus a Z. Another way, I like to have students think of new ways to looking at problems. So we looked at this in class today. My students looked at this and said, you know what, these letters X, Y, and Z really have nothing to do with the outcome of the problem. So other than telling us that the first row is X, or the first column is X, Y, and then Z, we started thinking, well, what if we created a matrix, and we're going to add make it an augmented matrix by adding that answer column. And we said, what if we just took a look at the different components of it and see if we really even need the different parts of it. So I'm just going to put in the coefficients of the matrix. And then finally I'll put in the last set. And a 6.1. So right now that matrix just represents the original matrix without any of the operations, without any of the variables. So not much is happening here, and it shouldn't. Just gives me the matrix back. So what I really want to do is I want to look at this and say, well, what could I do to eliminate some things? For example, I want to eliminate the number 1 in the Y column on the bottom so that all I have is Z, so that I can do something with it, so I can add different parts together. So if I start saying I am going to do some row addition, I can row add my answer matrix. So I just put in the answer. It assumes it's a matrix. Row number, if I wanted to add row number 1 with row number 3, it ends up in row number 3. So let's just do that. See what we end up with a 1 and a 3. And it'll give me a new answer matrix. And we see how we got a little bit worse there. No big deal, I can always go back and eliminate this. But basically what I'm doing is row operations. So if you remember from your high school days, or maybe you studied linear algebra, or even algebra 2, we do row reduction. So if I start typing in RREF, it's row reduction of a matrix, and my answer matrix is already there, even though it's been slightly changed because I added this to it. Really should not make a difference. So what row reduction is doing is it's going to give me an identity matrix, and in the augmented part, the last column, it should be my answers. So I just press REF, row reduction echelon form. It gives me that same solution matrix that we had earlier. Again, that doesn't help me answer the question, which is, what do each one of those, what is the sum of each one of the chickens add up to be? But that's got me thinking, there is other ways to solve matrices, including taking the original matrix that we had, and without the augmentation, doing a linear transformation on it. So again, we're going to go ahead and do the third way of doing a matrix, which is, let's just take, that's my system, so let's go with the matrix. We're going to go with a matrix that is my original 3x3, and I'm going to do inverse operations. So I'll type in my matrix really quick here. Oops, let me get the right one here. 1, 0, 1. And then finally my last row, 0, 1, 1. That's my original matrix. Now what I really want to do is multiply that matrix by my XYZ matrix. So I'm going to go in here and call up a matrix. I'm going to go with a 3 rows, 1 column. And I'm going to type in my X, my Y, and my Z. And I'm going to do this just to show you that when I do this operation, I will in fact get my original equation back. It doesn't have the zeros, but it does have the original. So what I want to do with this is I want to add something to it. What I really want is to solve the equation that has the last equals being my solution matrix. So 13 over 2, and that's not the original answer, so let me go back up here. 10.6, 8.5, and 6.1. I could solve this equation by just typing in the word solve and then solving for X and then Y and then Z. What I really want to do is think about how I can solve this system of equations or this matrix as if it were a single equation. Matrix A times X equals matrix B. So if we recall, in regular algebra we divide, but in matrices we can't divide, because division is not defined. But we can, if we think of multiplication as an inverse operation, we could just take the inverse of matrix A and multiply that by my answer matrix. So if I want the inverse, I'm just going to take it and raise it to the negative first power. And I'm going to multiply by my solution matrix. So what I'm basically just doing is solving the equation A times X equals B, and dividing or multiplying by the inverse of A, so that I get X is equal to A inverse B. And there we have A inverse B, yet another way of solving that same system of equations. So that's just a couple of ways to approach this. So let's find the final answer, which is, what is the answer when you take a chicken that weighs 6.5, a chicken that weighs 4.1, and a chicken that weighs 2 kilograms. What's the total weight? Total weight is 62 or 63 over 5, which is 12.6. If you don't want to hear the other solution to get this, I would stop the video now. If you want to see the other solution, here's what it is. Simply add up the first three panels. You have one chicken that's large, two chickens that are large. When you add them together, you get two large chickens, two medium chickens, and two small chickens. So you have two of each, which is adding all of your sums together and dividing by two, which will give you the 12.6 total. So add them all together, you get two of each, divide by two, you get one of each.